I'm here today with my Cobb Access Port V3 and my Fiesta ST. I'm here to talk about the different mounts you can use for your Access Port V3. The factory mount that comes with the Access Port is really quite a weak mount, and the reviews are generally pretty bad because the adhesive is a little bit too small and a little bit too weak. They use a 3 MPE foam, and that one, I used it for about a day and it fell off, and that seemed to be the experience of several other users if you check out the Cobb website as well. And it's not good for mounting on a curved surface. So originally I mounted it right here, you know, where it's kind of smooth and flat-ish, but it still didn't do a good job of holding up. On a textured surface like this, there'd be no way that would work. Another mount that Cobb offers is actually an A-pillar mount, and that one will actually clip around the A-pillar. Problem with that, it looks great, and it actually does work pretty good. I have a friend that has one on his Focus ST. Problem with that one is that it's about $65 US, which if you include the shipping and everything, for us Canadians, it's about $100. So not the best option in my opinion, because it can only be used for an access port, and it has the holes pre-drilled for the access port holster. And so you can't use it with a smartphone or any other accessory pretty much. So if you buy that $65 clip, you can only use it with one type of car, and you can only use it with one accessory, which is your access port. This here is the Scotchy Magic Mount, and this is the window slash dash version. They have two that kind of look like this. One's called the window, this is the window slash dash. The window one has a longer arm, but I figured the shorter arm version is gonna be a little bit stronger, less wiggling. It's a simpler design, just one piece into this ball type, screw type mount, and you can tighten that up. It's got pretty good resistance on there, and it's a magnetic plate here, and it works quite nice. I can use it with my smartphone, I can use it with the access port, and the nice thing is that the access port already has a magnetic back on it, so you don't need to use one of their plates. And you can save that for one of your smartphones, and it holds it quite nicely. Right now the ball isn't screwed down tight, but if that's screwed down, this isn't really gonna move. And I've been driving with this, and it doesn't wiggle or anything, which is one of the issues I had with my other mount. This here is what I was using before. It's the MPOW mount. It's just a generic mount off of Amazon. They had a sale on it, and it was about $7 or $8 with the Prime shipping. And so that was a really good deal, and it has a good sticky back on it, and this mount actually held onto the window fairly well. And one thing I like about this is it gives you the extra security because you have a bottom part, so that will support the bottom of your phone or your access port, and so it doesn't vibrate and doesn't fall down. And it also has these little arms on the side. And the arms have a foam in there, so it's actually easy to slide your phone or the access port out of the mount. But the problem is, if you wanted to switch this between your phone and your access port, you need to adjust this, the width. So every time you would need to change that and set it to the exact right width, because if you set it too tight, it's hard to take your phone out. If you set it too loose, it doesn't hold it very securely. But the problem I had with this one, well actually I had two problems with it, was this screw here gets loose pretty easily. So if you put a heavy phone on that cradle, every time you go over a bump, it loosens over time, and this screw, it would get pretty shaky. Even if I'm just using my phone for a GPS function, I found the screen to be really shaky, and I didn't really like this mount. But that was okay, I could live with that, especially with the access port, because it's a fair bit lighter. But over time, after about a month of use, or about 2 months of use, this clip here actually broke. And right now, it's in the secured position, and the flap actually doesn't hold down very tightly. So it used to lock down really nicely, but now you can just wiggle it. It's just pretty loose. It used to be, I guess there's a spring in there that used to be pretty strong. But not a bad mount overall for the price, not the most durable. Compared to this Scotchy unit, this one was about $30 for my friends over at Overdrive Auto Tuning. And so about $30, it is a good looking unit, it works well, and it's really low profile compared to this guy, which is much, much bigger. This is the packaging for that Magic Mount, the dash window version. It's really nice packaging, retail packaging obviously. And it has a two plates, so there's a little plate and a big plate. I didn't need to use either of them for the Cobb, but I did put one on my phone. I actually have a different Magic Mount. I'll show you here. I have this version here, which is for my Miata, and this one is the Magic Mount original. And it will mount to even a curved surface. It will mount because the plate that mounts actually is a flexible one. And you can, you know, if you heat that up, and the adhesive is pretty strong. It's got this red backing on there. It's stronger than that Cobb one, and it's a much bigger plate. And so this will mount somewhere like that, and you can put your phone on there. It's the same magnet as the dash mount, but different kind of application. You can put this one, I've seen some people put it down here. Not so good on a manual car, because sometimes you might, you know, hit it when you shift into fifth gear or what have you. But other cars it might work better. Depends on your layout, but I like to have this kind of up here. I'm gonna put this one in my Miata. But from this kit, I took the big plate and put it on my OnePlus. It's an adhesive plate. You can buy a set of these. They're about $15 for one big one and two smaller ones. The small one is actually strong enough to hold a phone like this. Big one kind of makes the case fit a bit funky. I would say use a small one. I don't know why I put the big one on. I guess I want it to be extra safe. With the magnet there, it just clips on really securely. Doesn't really move around too much, and it comes off. It's easy to take off, you know, if you're using one hand, just wrap around it, but you get that reassuring kind of sound there. And once it's on there, it's pretty nice. With the Cobb, it's the same idea. The reason why I really like this is because it's easy to take out. So Cobb on, off. You can use one of their plates. It probably will give you a stronger stick. I might do that with the smaller plate. I'll just add that on there for some extra security. So far on the street, I haven't had any issues, but for track use, I might do that and add an extra magnet plate on the back. By the way, I have my OBD cable running just up the A-pillar under the weather trim here. And that just clips in like that. Another tip I have is for the screen protector. Cobb does sell screen protectors for these guys, but all I did was I bought an iPhone, or I had some iPhone ones lying around, or for my old Note 3, I don't remember which one I used, but they're all really the same. And I just kind of cut it to shape. It's a little bit crude. There's some, you know, it's not a perfect fit, but it will give you that protection that you need. You know, if you're good with this, you can cut it really exactly to spec. Another mount that I really, really like is this dash crab here. This is the original dash crab. I've had this one actually since probably 2013. So 3 years now, and it's really held up really good. The reason I don't use this one for the access port is this is the older version where you actually need to use two hands to take something out. So you need to open it up and then take your access port out. With the Magic Mount, it's a lot easier to take it off than with this guy. This one is really strong though. I do use it for my phone on the track days, and it holds it really nicely. I've recorded video on there, use it for lap timing apps, what have you. And it works really nicely for those applications. It can hold a really wide phone as well, so it can open up quite wide. I used to use Samsung Note 3 and it held that phone just fine. I'm not sure how the Magic Mount would hold up with a Note 3, just because it's a wider, heavier phone. Whereas this one, you get a really secure grip because you have that clamping action from the sides. Doesn't slip or anything. It's got a little bit of a texturized finish there, so that red material there holds the phone nice and tight. And they're also priced at about $30, so right in line with the Magic Mounts. It's another great mounting option. Really depends on what your purpose is. For the easiest removal of your accessories, I still prefer the Magic Mount because it really is so painless. The dash crab, even with the latest generation, it does take a little bit more effort. It's pretty easy to do though. And yeah, it's held up really nicely over the years. This adhesive does leave a bit of a residue, so you do have to clean it really nicely. They were one of the first to use this kind of sticky adhesive instead of those, you know, rubber suction cup mounts. So Dash Crab, really an innovator in this field. This one, you know, you wash it and it gets sticky again. And over the years, the cheaper companies, even these cheap Amazon ones, they'll use that kind of same or similar material. I find this one's not quite as sticky. Doesn't leave as much of a residue, but again, this one failed on me after 2 months. That one I've had for 3 years, so it probably is worth paying that little bit extra. And yeah, this Skoshi Magic mount is my favorite mount for the Cobb Access Port V3. I like to mount it right here, same kind of position as what that A-pillar mount would do, because you don't need to take your eyes off the road to see it. You can read the gauges pretty clearly from the driver's seat. In contrast to if you mounted it down here, you would have to kind of look away to look at it. Some people have used vent mounts before. Those didn't work out nicely for me either. The problem with vent mounts is the Fiesta has these kind of angled vents, and the vent mounts don't really work properly with them. They'll end up facing either to the left or to the right. I also tried with the ones on the side here, but because they're so big, the vent mount doesn't properly clip on them.